Never sees Morgan in two dimensions. I saw her in three dimensions. And in three dimensions, she's absolutely the most gorgeous woman in the world.
Let's make sure we can hear her. Hello.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me? I just heard that lovely compliment. Thank you so much.
All we have is compliments.
You know,
for
the
you.
Compliment said, Morgan, the compliment said behind your back is the real compliment. I met you years ago. I'm trying to figure out who I was with. I was either with Lee Winkler or the girls from The Price is Right, who were my good friends. I met you somewhere, and I remember you were in white. You wore white, and your hair was outrageous big. I couldn't get over the porcelain features, and I said to myself,
Thank you so much.
No, you're breathtaking in person. The camera does not do it.
Let's do a real intro, though.
Let's do an intro.
All right, everybody.
Let's do an intro.
Now we want to welcome to the Jimmy Star Show with Ron Russell, the incredibly talented and stunningly gorgeous Morgan Fairchild. Hello, and welcome to the show.
Good morning. Good morning. Thank you for having me. How are you guys doing?
Fantastic.
I'm doing so well because you're so you're still stunningly beautiful.
And we're gay.
And we're married. So we're not, so, like, so we're not know, hitting on
we're
you.
We're not hitting on you. It's right. Just fabulous how fun you are.
No, really and truly.
This is my co-host, Ron Russell. He's our outrageous man about town.
And before we go any further, I want to invite you. You know, I'm bringing back my old TV show, Set the Record Straight. On that show was Betty Davis, Cliff Robertson, Tippi Hedren, Lauren Bacall, Tony Curtis. The list goes on of people I have interviewed over the years because I'm 80 years old and I've been in the business 64 years. So I knew the oldie ones. I want to invite you to be my first guest when I bring back Set the Record Straight. And I would be so honored to have you up there with those celebrities because you are really, I just saw you the other day on YouTube. We plugged in Hotel.
We watched the pilot episode of Hotel.
And you played a prostitute.
You were so fabulous.
I mean, gorgeous is not the word. And I said to myself, there's no money that it could ever buy her as a prostitute. That's bad casting. They should have gotten a woman less beautiful because, I mean, you'd have to be $1 million broad for the night.
Oh, thank you. You know, I took that because I had the opportunity to work with Betty Davis.
Yes, and my friend. She's my buddy.
Yeah. And she kind of like half adopted me. She was so kind and so wonderful and so scary.
I knew Betty very well. I tell everybody, I used to go to parties up in her place on Havenhurst. And she would take a drag on a cigarette and drink scotch at the same time. I thought that was fascinating, how the scotch and the cigarette. It's just amazing. she was quite a lazy. We toned in only because Sherry Belafonte is a dear friend.
Yeah, Sherry Belafonte, and so is Lainey Kazan. We saw in the things that they were on it, and then you were on it, and I was like, oh my gosh, and Morgan.
I love both of them. Yeah.
And Lainey Kazan is one of my most, I know Lainey 40-something years, we're very close. I adore Lainey. I adore her. So I was sitting there really in Hollywood heaven. Morgan Fairchild, Lainey Kazan, Sherry Belafonte. Of course,
and they've all been on our show now that you're on our show.
and especially that gorgeous, what's his name? Barbara Streisand's husband, what's his name?
Jim Brolin.
Oh, James Brolin.
Was he beautiful back then? Wow.
And I did Pee Wee's Big Adventure with him too.
So Morgan, what's going on now? What's happening? You want to go to work again?
All the time.
Well, not this year because the shutdown, there's just hardly anything going on. But one of the things I'm doing is I'm going to be doing some, I guess you'd call them virtual cons, you know, like comic cons. I'm doing two. I'm doing one for Fan Room Live on February 21st at 5 p.m. Eastern, 2 p.m. Pacific, and then I'm doing one for Wizard World on February 6th. That's at 4 p.m. Eastern, 1 p.m. Pacific. And so, you know, I try to stay in touch with fans and stuff over the years, and this year it's been kind of hard. So mostly it's been through Twitter and through Instagram and everything. But you know, so this is an opportunity to just reach out to people and answer some of the questions they're always asking me online and on Twitter and on Instagram. You know, how did you like working with so and so, or you know, what color lipstick is that?
So two things. Let me help with that. First of all, you guys, if you want to go to Morgan's Fan Room Live, you go to fanroomlive.com and you can get tickets. And for Wizard World, you go to wizardworldvirtual.com and just plug her name in, because they all have a bunch of celebrities coming up. And again, she's for Wizard World, she's on February 6th, and Fan Room Live, it's Sunday, February 21st. And we have a chat room full of people with about 8 countries represented. So I would like you just to say hi to everybody in the chat
room. Hello. Hello.
Oh, I love that.
Now, everybody's waiting patiently for me to ask the big question. I love how Tippi Hedren did this when I interviewed her. You could see it on YouTube. She said, and now Ron Russell's going to ask the most important question in the world. And that question is, what has ever been said about you that is not true, and you want to set that record straight, do it now, Morgan Fairchild.
And now look, she's got to think about it.
Well, you know, unless they say plenty of crap about me, that's not true.
Listen, there's so many things that have been said that aren't true. It's just hard to narrow it down. I think the main one is that because I play bitches, everybody thinks I am a bitch, but actually I'm this puppy dog from Texas. So, you know, but it's just hard to think of one. I mean, I've had women come up to me in ladies' rooms and accuse me of going out with their boyfriends, where I don't know who their boyfriend is, but their boyfriend, they apparently caught their boyfriend with some blonde, you know, that he said was me. And she said, okay, she's famous, I'll let it go.
I was having lunch one day on 3rd Avenue, on 3rd Street, and Joan Collins was in the table next to me. And then I got to talking to Joan Collins, and I said, you're really very sweet. You love playing bitches. And she looked at me, she said, it's easy, I am a bitch.
And said Joan, what?
She said, it's easy, I am a bitch. I said, Joan, you're far from a bitch. Joan Collins is one of the nicest, friendliest broads in the world.
She's a friend of mine too. I mean, we've worked together. We did a special back like in 84 called Blondes versus Brunettes, and of course we had shows on at the same time, so you always see everybody at the different events and galas and stuff, and affiliate conventions and stuff. So but we've been friends for a long time, and she's a wonderful person.
Did you ever hang out up at Billy Glenn at San Pietro's pizzeria with the rest of the soap opera people?
Once in a while I went in there.
I think I met you there. That's coming in. And I was with Janice Pennington and Diane Parkinson from The Price is Right.
Yes, and I know them both. Yeah.
That's where I met you. We were having pizza. Imagine meeting Morgan Fairchild.
Hang on, I want to go back, though. Hold on. All right. So first of all, you guys, Morgan she's followed me on Twitter for many years. You can follow her on Twitter. It's at Morg Fair, MorgFair. Her Instagram is Morgan Fairchild, #1 at the end of it. So I used to be a celebrity clothing designer. And so my favorite things that you've done are all the fashion things. I actually own paper dolls. Like I paid somebody to like record all of them, and I have them all on DVD the entire season, because it was like my favorite show. We had Terry Farrell on our show. We've had a bunch of the people from it on our show back in the day. I want you to give me some kind of insight and fans, because it's literally my favorite like series TV show ever. I know it did only went one season, but I loved it. So tell us.
Oh, thank you, because it's my favorite. It's my favorite one that I ever did. I love that show. I was just killed when it got canceled. I begged Len Goldberg every time I saw him at any gala in town. I would beg him to redo it. I said, hey, I can still play Racine. It doesn't say, you know, how old she's got to be, model agency head. No, I love that. Well, you want stories? What do you want?
give me some kind of a cool story that's not too long, since we don't have a lot of time.
I'm sorry, we only have 20 minutes.
Go. Let's tell a story.
Well, so we were going to shoot in New York. It was a 2-hour movie pilot, and we were going to shoot in New York. And I was very excited because one of my hobbies is paleoanthropology, and they were going to have a big paleoanthropology exhibit at the Museum of Natural History. And so Len called me up then and said, oh, you know, I just realized you don't have any exterior scenes, so you don't have to go to New York. I said, Len, you got to put me in something so I can go to New York. I'm worried about I want to see the skulls. So he wrote me a scene in. He wrote me a couple of scenes in. So I have one scene where I come outside of the plaza and say, where's my limo? And then I have one with Brenda Vaccaro. We're in the backseat
Brenda.
I love Brenda. And we're in the backseat of the limo. I really don't have anything to to say. She's chewing me out because her daughter has gotten suspended from Revlon or whatever because she got caught doing coke. And I'm like sitting here, I'm the model agency head, and I'm thinking I did great because I saved her. She didn't get fired. She just got suspended for a while. And she's screaming at me. And so I have nothing to say. So we're driving down and I'm like, you know, I had gloves. So I'm just like, wait, because Brenda's smoking, you know, and I'm waving. And then when she got out, I kind of ad-libbed and said, James, and if you can manage to hit Ms. Vaccaro on the way, big points. And you know, they left it in. So I was always like ad-libbing my way through all this stuff. So then I get to go to the museum for the thing. And I'm, you know, they've got all these fabulous skulls. It's like, if you're into paleoanthropology, it's first time they've had all the major finds together. So I was very excited to see it. So I'm walking around this big plexiglass square with this very primitive skull in there, big cheekbones, you know, very looks like very gorilla looking. And so these two guys are walking around it and saying, what is that? Because it had a big ridge on its head, the skull. And they said, what the hell is that? And I said, well, that's a sagittal crest. And, you know, that you can see where the cheekbones are and the muscles attached up there and had to attach to that because it's a grinding herbivore. And they looked in there looking at the little cards and they said, you know, where do you see that? And I said, no, I'm just telling you, it's not here. It should be here, but it's not here. And they said, aren't you Morgan Fairchild? How do you know this shit? I said, hey, it's just one of my hobbies. I'm just telling you what you're looking at.
It really was. It was so my favorite show. Everybody, if you're listening and you can find a way to watch it, it starred Morgan Fairchild, Terry Farrell, Nicholas Sheridan, Brenda Vaccaro, Dak Rambo, Mimi Rogers, and Lloyd Bridges were like the biggest names. It was a great show, especially if you're into modeling and fashion.
I worked with Brenda Vaccaro for 13 weeks on Sarah, a TV show that didn't make it at Universal. It was, she played her in a modern day cowboy girl. I was on a horse for 13 weeks. I was in pain.
Brenda, lucky you. Better than you than me, honey.
We used to hang out in her dressing room. This is a long story. I've told it before, but I won't
make it short.
I can't tell it now. Where she was sitting, it's too long of a story.
That's also
it won't come off right. But anyway, Brenda is a sweetie. She's an Italian girl from Texas, and her parents owned a pizzeria in Texas.
I know. We know each other for decades. Yeah. I love her.
You know what? Tell her Ron Russell said he's mad at her because I called her up not long ago, and her husband answered, and he was rude, and he said, Brenda doesn't speak to people anymore. I said, what the hell are you talking about? Put Brenda on, and he hung up on me.
Well, maybe that's why I haven't heard from her in a while.
her husband's crazy. I heard he was a big drug.
You know what else? There's not a show that you weren't on in the 80s and the 90s and now, because I went on your IMDb and like you're even, except for last year, you're working all the time. One of the shows that, I'm bringing it up because he's a big Fran Drescher fan, and she was on Happily Divorced, and we've had both of them, her and her husband, both on the show.
Oh, I know Peter well.
We saw Peter before this COVID thing. Do you live in California or New York? I kind of had the impression you lived in New York.
You know, I lived in New York in the 70s, and then I lived there for a year when I was doing a show in the 90s. I go back and do theater occasionally, but really I live in L.A. But I love Fran. She is just so fabulous, and she does such wonderful things for charity, and she's such a talent. I love her.
Meanwhile, she came on our show in a white death robe.
She didn't know it was video.
She didn't know it was video. She thought it was radio. So there's Fran, and she said, oh my God, this is television. Nobody told me.
I had to ask. I got up early and washed my hair.
She did not have a stitch of makeup on. Her hair was soaking wet and she was so pretty.
She's beautiful. And she's the main thing. She's also beautiful on the inside. She does so much work for cancer and all these different charities. Just a wonderful, lovely lady and so sweet. I mean, it's always a joy to work with her because she's just so sweet and very giving. Not every actress you work with is very giving to the other actresses.
Fran didn't come from far from where I live. We live maybe a couple miles apart. And I know the type of woman Fran Drescher is because I dated a lot of girls from Flushing.
Before I came out.
When I was discovering who I was.
We want to hear those stories.
Anyway, the girls from Flushing, Jewish girls, basically, you know, I'm Italian, so we used to go out with the Jewish girls because they used to say terrible things if they did, which is not true. But Fran Drescher is a real, what we call in Yiddish, hengishim rud. She's a homebody, good girl. She loves her parents. She loves Peter to death. I am so happy. I'm going to give a little bit of gossip. I understand from the birdies that Peter and Fran may be living together again because they love and adore each other. They just won't have sex. Because Fran said it's not the most
I know important. So many marriages like that.
Yeah, well, I think Peter was hysterically crying when I spoke to him about it. And he said, I love Fran more than anything. I'm just so sorry that I'm gay and I can't be the guy she wants. And I said, bullshit. Every woman, I'm 80 years old. If I tell you the chicks that chase me, old ladies, they want to marry me. They said, I don't want sex. I just want a husband like you. I said, what makes you think I'm 80 and I don't want sex? You know, as long as it's...
Well, if that, Ron, if that is true, I'm so happy for them because I know they adore each other and I'm just happy for whatever makes them happy.
Well, it's rumored. I should call Peter and ask him about it. But I hope so because I love the both of them. Peter is one of the sweetest, kindest, most gentle men in the world. And Fran is the same. God made them to be together. I don't know why... He was born gay, but that was the mistake. But I think they can rectify it. You know what? As you get older, sex is not the most important thing. Cuddling and hugging is. Don't you agree?
Well, it's all important. But the hugging and the cuddling is also very important. And, you know, and also the character side. The older you get, the more you appreciate people who are kind and who have a really good sense of humor and who can keep you entertained and are fun to be with.
I want to ask another question. If Cary Grant were alive today and wanted to go to bed with you, would you?
Well, if I weren't involved, you know, I met Cary. We hosted Chinese New Year's together at Caesar's Palace one year. He and Greg Peck and I, and we all flew in on the Caesar's jet together. That was fun. Oh we got,
You're beautiful and they're both gorgeous. They're like, Cary, they're so gorgeous.
I told you, Jimmy and I are married 9 years and I told Jimmy I cheat.
Cary Grant.
Well, he was gorgeous, as was Greg Peck. But the funny thing is, Willie Nelson's an old friend of mine. And Willie had been playing at the amphitheater. And so he and his wife had came off stage and they said, oh, we're going to Dinah Shore's house over in Bel Air. You want to go? And I said, well, you know, I don't really know Dinah. I don't want to crash your party. And they said, oh, no, it's real casual. Come and go. So I get in the limo. We drive over the hill to Bel Air. We walk in and there is a buffet laid out in the foyer. Beautiful. And there's Greg Peck standing there. And so Willie just stopped cold. And I said, are you okay? And he says, I love Gregory Peck. Gregory Peck is my favorite actor. And I said, have you ever met him? He says, no. Did you know him? I said, yeah, we've done some charity work. Yeah, do you want to meet him? So I take Willie Nelson over to meet Gregory Peck. They gab for hours. They gabbed and gabbed and gabbed. So finally, we're in the limo driving back over the hill. And Connie and I are talking. And Willie says, Gregory Peck thinks I am a good actor. And I said, oh, that's great. He saw Electric Horseman and all this. And Connie and I are talking. He said, no, really, Gregory Peck thinks I can act. And I said, well, that's great, Willie, because you are good, you know. And he says, no, really, he thinks I can act. I wonder if he's ever heard me sing. So I said, I don't know. So cut to, you know, like a year later, I'm getting on the jet, the Caesar's jet to go to Vegas to host Chinese New Year. So I get on, there's Gregory Peck, there's Cary Grant. And so Gregory Peck leans out of the aisle and says, Morgan, you're a good friend of Willie Nelson's, right? And I said, yeah. And he says, you know, how can you get me in touch with him? Can you give me some contact info? And I said, oh, sure. It's in my luggage when we get up back then. I said, when we get to the hotel. And so Cary Grant leans out over the aisle and he says, who? Who are we talking about? Now, this is like 1984 or something. You know, Willie's everywhere. And who are we talking about? And Greg says, Willie Nelson, the country music singer. And Cary says, oh, is he that chap that sings? And he starts into this thing that sounds like On the Street Where You Live from My Fair Lady, but it's the Cary Grant version of On the Road Again. And I wish I had it on tape. So then I get to the hotel and I call Willie and I say, now listen, Gregory Peck wants your contact info. I would never give your contact info without asking you. Is it okay? He says, oh my God, yes, it's okay. What do you think he wants? I said, I don't know. He didn't say. He says, Oh, he thinks I can act. I wonder if he wants me to be in a movie with him. I said, I don't know, Willie. He didn't tell me. And so finally, it turned out Greg was producing the Oscars that year, and he wanted Willie to sing on the Oscars. But as big an honor as that is, I know Willie would have rather be in a movie with Gregory Peck.
Morgan, did you know Lee Winkler from Global Enterprises? Everybody's business manager.
I'm sorry, say again?
Lee Winkler from Global Enterprises. He was every star's a business manager. Oh, yes. Everybody in Hollywood that was hot. Burt Reynolds, all the way down the line. That's how
I didn't know him, but I met him.
You've met him. Okay. He was my best and dearest and closest friend for 40-something years. We're like brothers.
Everybody in the chat room like loves you. Everybody in the chat room, I think, was worried that you were going to be a bitch like you are on TV too. Because they're all like, oh my God, she's so fabulous. She's so wonderful. We love her. Best story ever. That shows that how good an actress you are.
Out of all the celebrities I have met, and I have met everybody in Hollywood 50 years of work of being around, Rhonda Fleming was the only bitch that I ever met.
Who?
Rhonda Fleming was not.
Oh, really?
She was a stuck-up snob because she was married to Man Thea. She's dead. She was married to Man Thea.
Look at her face.
No, she was married to Man Thea, and she thought who the hell she was. And she was Jane Russell's best friend. And Jane Russell was my sister, my dearest friend in the world. And she was so rude to me when I asked her to come on, set the record straight. And she talked down like I was garbage.
So hang on.
And my show was number one for a long time.
We have 2 minutes, and here's what we're going to do. First of all, you guys.
You're coming back, Morgan.
This is Morgan Fairchild, you guys. She's fabulous. She's wonderful. She hasn't aged a day since she was unbelievable.
I don't even want to talk about it because it's scary.
Now, everybody's texting me messages how beautiful you are.
Morgan.
Tell them thank you.
Morgan, listen, I don't blow smoke, okay?
Say again, I can't hear you.
I don't blow smoke up butts, but if I didn't know who you were and I met you, I would think you were 45 years old.
Oh, well, thank you. I got a birthday next week.
There we go. So everybody,
you have not aged at all.
You guys follow
have
Morgan?
Have you seen Sophia Loren's movie?
No.
Oh my God, she doesn't even look like her anymore. She aged terribly, and I made a movie with Sophia in 1959, and she was breathtaking. And then I love her.
She's one of my faves. I love her.
She's a very, very sweet person, by the way. Very lovely woman.
I know. I've met her a few times.
Very lovely, but she don't look good. You have to do something.
Well, my God, she's getting in her late 80s. Give the lady a break.
I'm 80. She's 86. I was 19 when we did That Kind of Woman with Deb Hunter, who remained my friend 50-something years. Deb and I were like brothers. And Jimmy met him right before he passed away, 2 weeks before he passed.
Hang on, let's go. I got to get this in.
Yes, go.
All right, so you guys, this is Morgan Fairchild, you guys. First of all, follow her on social media. It's MorgFair on Twitter. It's Morgan Fairchild number one on Instagram. On Saturday, February 6th, you can go to wizardworldvirtual.com to get tickets. And she's doing a virtual meet and greet for Wizard World. Then she's doing Fan Room Live Sunday, February 21st, 5 p.m. Eastern Time. Again, a virtual meet and greet. You can do all kinds of cool things with her. She's fabulous. You see how nice she is on the show. You're going to have a blast. You know, please support her. Follow her in social media. Watch all her things. You got to watch Paper Dolls. It's fabulous. You also got to watch Fashion House. I loved Fashion House. Also,
I
was a clothing designer, so all the fashion stuff was my favorite. And you guys, she's not a bitch in real life. You don't have to worry about it. You see that in her Twitter. She's very cool.
No, but I said to Tippi Hedren, when I interviewed her, I said, when you did the birds, and the scene where you go into the bedroom, and what's her name, that wonderful actress is in the bed, and you have to bring her tea. I didn't get it. Your character changed. And Tippi said to me, well, she suggested to me I not play it like a bitch because people are not going to like me. She said, so we turned it around and I went in very caring and sweet. And I said, how could your character do that? She was a bitch to you, the old lady. She didn't want you with her son and made it quite obvious. Tippi said, well, they did it because she's a grande dame. What was her name? The one that was married to the old man forever. Batteries are not occluded. What's her name? English actress.
Anyway, she was in
the birds with Tippi Hedren. Tippi Hedren, do you know Tippi?
Yeah.
Love, adore,
she's wonderful.
Adore. I love her more than anything in the world.
Do people ever give you like roles now?
I didn't finish. Tippi Hedren and I were at Blackwell's funeral at the Four Seasons Hotel. We got drunk and we were making out.
That was before me.
Tippi and I were hugging and kissing. We love each other so much.
Do they bring you roles that you, I noticed one of the films that you've done recently and your character's name was Grandma, which I have a hard time seeing you play a grandma. Because you don't look like grandma. But like, do they give you, are some of your roles that you're getting now not playing the bitch?
Oh, yeah. I played a grandmother in that one. I wore a short gray wig in it. And I played Mrs. Santa Claus in one that was out like last year and ran again this year. And I did another playing a mother of some young man in a romantic comedy for another one, Christmas in Vermont, you know. So, I don't always have to play the bitch. Although it's a lot of fun.
I want to make one point. Today, I'm a senior citizen. I have 6 movies waiting for me to make. I've just shot 4. I am working now more than I ever did when I was a young man. Because when I was a young man, the competition was tremendous. I was up against all the gorgeous men of Hollywood. Now I'm the only old bag that's still alive, and they grab me when they can. because I still can speak and I can see. And so I just want you to know out there that Like Lauren Bacall said to me, no movie is old until after you've seen it. And I want to say one thing. A movie star is over ever in Hollywood. It's a legend. It's something they gave us. It's history. And Morgan's work and Jane Russell's work and Tippi's and everybody else's work is history. Never in front of me ever refer to it as, that old stuff, because I will punch you.
You're fabulous. So Morgan, thank you so much.
Another thing, Morgan,
we gotta go.
I gotta ask her.
I know, but let
us take you to lunch. I want to talk to you about Set the Record and in a movie that you made.
Well, when COVID is over.
When COVID's over,
I'm not going anywhere now. I am the best COVID person. I go nowhere. I wear my mask, and I'm living at home.
I will call you, and Jimmy has maybe a good part for you in a movie. And I definitely want to put you up there with my celebrity list of great stars.
And
everybody wants Set the Record Straight back. That's all they do is they write. So it'll be a TV show. It's a good one. It's not the crazy one like here where we talk pretty and get nuts. It's a very, very sophisticated.
We were clean with her anyway. So everybody, this is Morgan Fairchild. Please go to fanroomlive.com, book a ticket, meet her again, follow her on social media. We want to thank you for coming on the show.
Look how beautiful she is.
They're doing a close-up now.
I cannot believe
that
your beauty has lasted this long and is still stunningly gorgeous.
Well, you're very kind. I appreciate it.
No, I'm not kind. I'm telling the truth. Kindness doesn't go in this.
So anyway.
If you were an ugly troll and I said it, then I'd be kind.
So Morgan, we want to thank you so much. Congratulations on everything. We're big fans. We love your work.
Yes, and now that I know
thank you, guys.
I see how sweet you are. Now I'm even far more fond of you than just your beauty. I know that you're a good girl.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye, guys. Bye-bye. Have a wonderful week.
Thank you, sweetheart.
Thank you for coming on. What a lovely girl.
Yes.
She's really terrific.